Hello, my friends. In this video, I'm going to give you some update regarding my pregnancy. I am 26 weeks pregnant. I have no idea how many months that really is because the whole month calculation thing during pregnancy is very confusing to me. And yesterday I did a Google search because I really try to figure out, because people keep asking, oh, how many months, blah, blah, blah. And I really don't know how to, you know, as I say, the calculation is quite crazy. So it says 40 divided by 9. So each month is supposed to be 4.4 weeks. And that's just confusing to me. Anyway, I know I'm 26 weeks and I'm not yet third trimester yet. They say it's probably up to, I think, 31 weeks or something like that. To me, the whole calculation is off. That's the bottom line. But I am 26 weeks pregnant. And yeah, let me stand up and then show you how big I am. Ooh. Hope you can see. Wow, the clothes is all rolled up. Okay, I have a, I'm sorry. I have the pregnancy on, no, maternity thing underneath anyway. So that's the belly right now. It's very obvious now. And the funny thing, because last time, I remember when I did my second trimester, last time was second trimester update. I was saying that the colleagues at work, nobody noticed and things like that. But right now, everybody, I don't have to say anything, everybody recognized it and came up to me. And then, you know, congrats and things like that. So it's absolutely obvious now. And also I do feel pretty good in terms of energy wise and everything else. Just I do feel pretty good. And previously, the first trimester, even up to part of the second one, even though I'm still in the second trimester, I slept a lot. But now, especially this week, week 26, my hours of sleep reduced dramatically. I don't know why, but I woke up, I usually go to bed around 9:30, and I wake up at this week, wake up consistently around 5, and then past couple of days moved to 6 o'clock. So amount of sleep reduced, energy wise still pretty much the same. So which is interesting to me. I thought I would be like, you know, I need a lot of sleep. Usually I do need a lot of sleep, but not this week. Food wise, the major thing still, again, I follow my, what's that called? I let my body tell me what my body needs. Sometimes, a lot of times I need a lot of, I do eat a lot of fresh vegetables. And fruits, especially citrusy kind of fruits, I think probably my body really needs those components, you know. And another crazy thing is I actually broke my tooth. Crazy, isn't it? Broke my tooth because all my front teeth, these are all either with a crown or with a veneer. So they are all being fined into little tiny things. I totally regret what I did this years ago, totally regret, but what can I do? So all my front teeth are tiny, small. They cover with the crown and all that crazy stuff. And then one night when I was traveling, I actually broke in the middle of sleep. I broke it. And I probably was tired and grinding a lot. So, and then I realized, oh my goodness, I probably need to supplement myself with the calcium. Because it's logical, right? The baby is growing. The baby needs a lot of calcium to build the structure, the bones and this and that. And the baby takes away all the calcium and I have in my bones and my teeth. And obviously I will be lacking calcium in my teeth and my bones because baby needs it. And that's why my teeth are not as strong, and I could break it myself. It was unbelievable. It's crazy. So I start supplementing calcium as well, and drink more milk. And then recently I had a leg cramp in the middle of the night, so I feel like probably once again the importance of a calcium magnesium supplement. So I stick with make sure I do take them pretty regularly. And another problem that occur in the past, I would say probably 3 to 4 weeks already, is really the gum bleed, the bleeding gum. So before, up to 22, 23 weeks, I had no issue in terms of bleeding gum, but now it started to become an issue now. So these are the troubles that I have currently, and also the round ligament pain, especially the right side. It's not just occasional, it's like almost all the time I feel just the achy over there. I suspect I may have some kind of muscle tear or ligament tear, something like that, because it's there constant all the time. So whenever I have chance, whenever I feel that, I would rub it. So basically those are the main trouble that I'm experiencing right now. So bleeding gum. Oh, one more, constipation. Oh my goodness, that was the bad one. And especially during the fall season, you see a lot of persimmons, the orange stuff. I love it, so sweet, so I just love eating it, and that caused constipation. So I did have problem with constipation, but I've been also taking colace for a couple of weeks just to bypass that stage, and hopefully can help me in terms of having more regular and soft bowel movement. I know it sounds gross, but that's another major issue that I experience. So at this point, I do experience some problems associated with pregnancy, and they are getting me right now. So constipation, round ligament pain, bleeding gum. What else I said before? These are the main, and also make sure I do have calcium supplements to build up, to provide enough supply in terms of tissue building, bone building, structure building. Okay, weight-wise, this month, actually the whole month from beginning of the from November 10th until like now, the weight control is quite steady. It's quite steady, but when I weigh myself today, I'm above 150 now. So I total gain for now, it's reached to 21 pounds. So that seemed a lot, but the past month was very, very steady, because I'm not on any kind of diet, because previously I was very into paleo and even ketogenic diets, but right now I'm not on any kind of, but I still do watch for my carbs intake. I usually don't have any carbs in terms of starchy carbs before 12 o'clock, and then I will have that for dinner, lunch kind of thing. About 3 4 times a week I usually have lunch and dinner combined together. I'll eat that at the 3 o'clock, something like that, and then some fruits. So I'm not on any kind of diet, but I do track, I do write down everything that I eat, and that helps me in terms of maintain the weight somehow. But obviously I do it still steadily gaining weight, which is all right, which is okay. And I think in terms of the whole development wise, I think I'm okay. I probably would at the end would gain at least 35 pounds for this one. And believe it or not, I gained about 70 for my first pregnancy. The second pregnancy, I probably gained 50. And if I can, adjust and then try to keep it in bay in terms of weight gain and reach to 35, I'm okay with that as well. So that's about it. And also, I got my Fitbit. I don't know why it took me so long. This is another thing. It took me so long to get it, and ever since I had it, I love it so much. So I also maintain almost 10,000. Only past 2 days was very busy. I was up to about 8,000, and I just too tired to finish it up. But most of the time, I do have 10,000 steps a day locked in, and yeah. So, so far so good. Some problems, which is, you know, understandable. I know they are also temporary as well. I kind of able to deal with those problems and enjoying everything that's going on right now. Yeah, that's it. That's my 26 weeks up pregnancy update. And I guess that's it. If you have any questions, leave your comments down below. And I will see you next time. Goodbye, my friends.